What's up? I'm Ferrari with University TV here at Guilford College in Greensboro, North Carolina. You ready to tour this campus? It's listed on the National Register of Historic Places.
Guilford College is located in central North Carolina's Greensboro, which is the third largest city in the state. The campus is just minutes from downtown and a few hours from whitewater rafting, skiing, and beaches.
We have about 350 acres. We use about 110 of them. So our lakes and woods have been scenes of various things within Greensboro's history in terms of civil rights or in terms of environmental protection, etc.
The college was founded back in 1837 by Quakers. Right, Nathan? That's right. It was the only college in the South to stay open throughout the entire Civil War. In fact, where the college now sits was once a site on the Underground Railroad. Yeah!
Of the 2,725 students on campus, 60% are from outside the state of North Carolina, and more than 19% are students of color. Both genders are equally represented, with 50% women and 50% men. To gain admittance into Guilford, the college uses a holistic approach when reviewing its applicants. In addition, the average unweighted GPA is a 3.1, but if testing isn't your strong suit, a student may elect to submit a portfolio of written work instead. Tuition and fees for all students is the same, approximately $29,000 a year. Those who choose to reside on campus will pay an extra $8,000. Guilford College offers nearly 40 different majors, 54 minors, and 5 pre-professional programs. The most popular majors are English, biology, business management, and psychology.
One of the things that we've developed here at Guilford in the past few years is this thing called the Guilford Undergraduate Symposium, where students will present research work that they've been doing in a variety of different kinds of classes, everything from chemistry to, you know, my English classes.
With a green rating of 95 by the Princeton Review, Guilford eats, sleeps, and breathes clean air, literally. There is a strong focus on environmental sustainability in the curriculum, as well as compost and recycled materials to maintain the efforts on campus.
Sticking with their emphasis on environmental sustainability, Guilford has teamed up with FLS Energy to install 188 rooftop solar thermal collector panels, heating over 9,000 gallons of water in the dorms daily.
It is the largest solar thermal project ever attempted in a college university in the United States.
Of the 126 full-time faculty members, half hold tenure and 108 have a PhD or terminal degree in their field of study. The average class size is 19, with a student to faculty ratio of 15 to 1.
Classes are small, which I love. I think the biggest class I had here was about 20 students, and now I have a class of 5. So it's really wonderful, and you're able to get a lot done, and the teachers are really attentive to your needs, and they get to know you better. So they're able to understand your learning style and how you like to do things in the classroom.
I think that our strongest assets are our faculty and the other students as well. We've got students who really want to get involved and who really want to participate in the classroom. It's very rare to see just a straight lecture, although that does happen.
One of the things that really happened to me as a student was that I came to value that these really, I mean, deep personal relationships with faculty members, just a kind of mentorship that goes well beyond just, you know, an A on a paper or a good job at the end of a class discussion.
The Guilford Quakers compete in the NCAA Division III level as a member of the Old Dominion Athletic Conference with 18 men's and women's athletic teams.
So whether or not you really like sports or not, or that particular sport you're watching, you're surrounded by friends and you always meet new people, and so it kind of just, your body of friends just grows every time you go to an event.
Roughly 77% of the student body lives on campus in one of the 6 residence halls, 2 apartment complexes, or 4 themed houses.
There's plenty of stuff to do on campus. You could stay in shape in this brand new fitness center like these students are doing now. You could play on one of the sports teams. You could join one of the over 40 student clubs and organizations on campus. I'm Green Lake Guilford, so I'd probably be in the Organic Gardening Club and the Outdoor Adventure Club. But for right now, I'm gonna come to the island. You wanna spot me? Ooh.
Guilford is also home to WQFS, their nationally ranked radio station.
Serendipity. It's kind of seen as the college party weekend, but it's a whole lot more. It's not, that's what the students might consider it, but its real intent is just kind of a let go weekend and just relax and take a study break.
We have a concert Friday nights, and we bring in the band that the campus asks for. And it goes from everything from midnight breakfast to doing events. We had a street fair where all the organizations on campus kind of did a little bit. We had jello wrestling with rugby, ultimate frisbee. We had the prom dress rugby game with the girls.
Nice. Now that our tour is over, it looks like I've got a little time for a volleyball game. So thanks for hanging out with me in Greensboro. I'm Ferrari with University TV, and I'll see you later.